Good day, YouTube. My name is Joseph Warren, and today I'm going to give you four things to leave behind in 2020 so you can make amazing decisions in 2021. What are your thoughts on the year 2020? For me, it's been one of the weirdest years of my life, without a doubt. One of the many weird parts about it is the fact that you can feel a sense of nostalgia for January and February of 2020. If you don't remember that period of time, that was right before lockdown, when everything was really going down or going crazy in China, but things weren't too serious yet in the United States. There were maybe one or two cases. During that period of time in February, I was a judge for a speech contest, and I remember one of the contestants gave an extremely memorable speech. It was a young Chinese lady who was talking about a form of chaos theory called the butterfly effect. The butterfly effect is basically this idea that a butterfly can flap its wings in China and it leads to a hurricane happening in Florida. And basically that's what happened this year. So it was a very telling speech. She ended up winning the speech contest. And her point in saying that was that our actions have massive power. So she started talking about how at the time there was a rumor going on in Chinese social media that a group of adventurous eaters had gotten together and decided that it was a good idea to eat a bat, and that that had led to the spread of the virus. And she was talking about how decisions and actions that are done out of malice, out of cruelty, or out of greed can cause a ripple effect that causes massive problems in the world. And how on the opposite side of that, actions and decisions that are made out of kindness, out of love, out of courage, can cause a ripple effect that makes the world a better place. So the whole point was that our actions have massive influence on a global scale. So with that in mind, I want to talk about the things that we can let go of in 2020 to make 2021 our best year ever. Number one, overthinking. Let's leave overthinking in 2020. Overthinking is when you waste time and energy thinking of all the things that could go wrong, all the things that you don't want to happen. The problem with it is it actually makes those things more likely to happen. Thoughts are powerful. There's a saying that thoughts are things. And it's true. If you think about it, anything that's ever been created by humankind was once just a thought in someone's head. Before the car was invented, it was an idea or a thought in someone's head. So in 2021, let's be careful about the thoughts that we give power to. Let's not give power to thoughts about fear, doubt, and defeatism. And instead, let's give our power to thoughts about purpose, passion, and excitement. So how can you do that? How do you give power to a thought, or how do you take power away from a thought? So contrary to what most people would think, if you want to take power away from a negative thought, you don't resist it. Instead, you just notice it, observe it, and let it go. If you want to give power to a positive thought, what you do is affirm it. And I like to think about that as kind of like what rappers do. So if you think about the rapper 2 Chainz, he'll always do a line and he'll be like, I'm the greatest rapper alive. True. So you can do the same exact thing with your thoughts. If you have a positive thought, a thought that uplifts you and makes you feel good, just say true or that's right. And you're affirming that thought and giving it more power. When you have a negative thought, as we all do, or a thought you're just like, wow, that's a weird thought, just observe it and let it go. So if you want to stop overthinking, what should you do instead? If you're going to think with a purpose. Set a time where you're only going to think about one specific thing. Say it's a big decision that you're going to make, and only think about that thing. And you can think about all the things that can go wrong. Write it down. Write the worst case scenario, the best case scenario, your plan B, your plan C. And then after the time is over, make it so that you have to make a decision at that period of time. Because a lot of times overthinking will cause people to not be able to make decisions, so they'll hesitate, and we're living in a fast-paced world. You need to be able to make decisions quickly and efficiently. Number two, waiting. Let's stop waiting and let's start making things happen. Life is not a fairy tale, and no one's just gonna come along and give you everything. You have to go out there and get it. So in 2021, I want you to think about what you want and go for it. Try it out and see what happens. The worst that could happen is that it doesn't work out and you just learn something new. But either way, it's progress and you're moving forward. Number three, letting external things have control over you. One of my favorite books is the book Meditations by Marcus Aurelius. It's written by a Roman emperor and Stoic philosopher during the time of a plague. It's actually his personal journal. And in that book, he gives an amazing quote. The more you value things outside your control, the less control you have. So the main idea is that you should make a clear distinction between what you can control and what's outside of your control. And you should focus only on the things that you can control. The things outside your control should not affect your well-being or any other factor. They shouldn't make you feel bad or good because they're outside your control. The only thing that should affect you are the things in your control, and you should do everything you can to make sure they're right. So let me give you an example. Let's say you're walking down the street and you wave at someone and smile, and they wave and smile back. The fact that they waved and smiled back should not make you feel happy. What should make you feel happy is the fact that you did the right thing and you kindly waved and smiled at them. Now, let's say you wave and smile at someone and they scowl at you. In that case, that shouldn't make you feel bad at all because it's outside of your control how someone reacts to you. Instead, you should just say, that's that person's problem. I did the right thing by waving and smiling, and just let it go. So it's really this idea of not letting external things have control over your internal well-being, because you can always control that. And I think it's just a great idea for modern times, because we're living in a world where you can gain a real tangible advantage by having control over your attention and your reactions to the things that are happening. Number four, for the love of all that is good, please stop panic buying toilet paper. I remember reading an article about this earlier this year, and the reason that people panic buy toilet paper is because it gives them the illusion of control. Because it's a big, bulky product, it makes people feel like they're safe and secure. Instead of looking to external things like toilet paper as your source of safety, make your own safety. Make your own security. Stop avoiding problems and distracting yourself from them and face them head on. Fix the internal and the external will take care of itself. If you do this, you'll be saving yourself a lot of stress and anxiety, and you'll also be saving a lot of other people stress and anxiety when they're looking for toilet paper. So thank you very much for watching. Comment below with one thing that you're gonna let go of or leave behind in 2020. I'd love to see your answers. Be sure to like and subscribe and to tune in tomorrow, where I'll be talking about things that we can start doing in 2021 to make it the best year ever. Thanks again for watching and happy almost New Year.